Right, here we have another question from our Ask the Angler feature on our Preston Innovations Facebook page. This one comes in from Patrick O'Connell. So Des,
yeah.
And I think this is probably a question you've been asked many times. Commercial fishing, when your peg's fizzing and you can't get a bite,
how do you catch?
What do you do? And Patrick said, you know, do you go shallow? Do you go deeper? Tell us what you do.
It's very difficult. It's probably one of the biggest questions I get asked, like you said. The obvious thing is feed. I always find if you go into a venue which is fizzing really bad, you know it's going to fizz. Obviously, paste is a very good bait.
Right, that's interesting.
Very good bait. I'm not a massive, I don't really do a lot of paste fishing, but I know, especially early summer, April, May time when things start warming up, paste can be really, really good.
Right. So what is it that makes it fizz?
It's the silt. It's the silt on the bottom. Yeah, sometimes I have been to an odd venue where I'm loose feeding shallow and you get the odd bubble come up. And sometimes it's where the fish are going around shallow and they're gilling a little bit. You get the odd bubble, but nothing like...
So when it's proper, really...
That's the bottom. That's where the fish are attacking the bottom.
So the fish are in the silt and it's
and all the gases. All the gases are coming out. If you ever get into a lake, I've been into lakes before with like chest waders on doing some sort of work party. And you can go on the hard bits of the bottom, and all of a sudden you put your foot down into a soft bit, which is a silt, and straight away you get all these gases come up. So that's what it is. The fish are in the silt. It's very difficult.
And that's why you struggle to get bites, because your bait's sort of masked
silt. Yeah, it's very difficult. And sometimes it fizzes really, really bad. And I think you think there's a lot of fish in your peg. Sometimes I don't think it is. I think it's like maybe two or three fish.
And they're creating all that.
They're creating all that bubbles. Like I said, paste is very, very good. The next thing is obviously shallow, like Patrick said. That's the option. If you go to a place where it's fizzing really
come bad, off the bottom.
Well, just fish shallow.
Right. Really. So out of the way of the fizzing and the silt and all
well,
the
yeah, you just fish shallow and try and bring the fish up off the bottom, you know, up into like sort of...
And get them out of that silt.
Get them out and they're fizzing shallow. The next thing is try and find hard bottom. On most lakes, you either fish up against an island. Because on every lake, if you say you've got an island or you're inside margin, if you walk in the margins, it's like walking on solid concrete. And it goes down the slope, and as the sort of silt starts, it goes soft.
Yeah.
And in the summer, really important. That's why these big weights on commercials now, a lot of it is done in the margins and at top five or top four, wherever that silt just stops.
Right,
and that's where
you're getting onto the hard bottom.
Yeah, and you can put a big plummet. I use like a 20 or 30 gram plummet. I use 20 grams normally. In the summer, you put a 30 on, so you can feel
the actual clonk.
You're on the stones, or sometimes you feel your plummet going down stones. You know that's where you want to be fishing, especially in the summer. In the winter, it's different. Most venues don't fizz
in the winter
because the silt is sort of dead. The fish don't sort of attack the bottom for bait as heavily as what they do in the summer. So that's the most important thing. Try and fish up to a feature. That's what I do, either on the inside or try and get to an island.
So what you're saying, the secret to avoid the fizzing is not to fish where the fizzing might occur in the silt.
If you have to do it, feed very little.
So it doesn't
get the fish really crazy competing sometimes. And also a really good tip is, if it does start fishing, say you've been fishing for, you know, half an hour to an hour, and you've caught a couple of fish, and all of a sudden the peg starts fizzing, plumb up a meter away and start again.
Move away
from that and just start again. You'll be amazed. You can have a good little run of fish and then that peg starts fizzing, and then you can just move away another meter and start again. And you can always eventually go back on the line that you actually started
when it's settled down.
So it's them little tips that can catch you a lot more fish in the summer especially.
So some great tips there. So
yeah, good question, one of the biggest questions I get asked.
Yeah, so avoid the silt if at all possible, get on a nice hard bottom, plumb up, use a heavy enough plummet, look for that plummet sinking into the silt. And if you do have to fish in that area, try and get the fish shallow and out of that silt.
Big baits as well, big baits, worms, big worm on the hook, even though you might just feed it with pellets, try a big worm. Or like I said, paste, especially early summer, can be deadly. For more great videos like this, just subscribe to our YouTube channel.